Good day, criminology students, and welcome to the first chapter of our lecture video discussion of traffic management and accident investigation with driving. Today, we are going to talk about the historical development of human methods on how did people transport their goods from ancient times before that technology comes. So, paano ba trina-transport nila, nililipat nila yung mga gamit or mga cargoes from one place to another during the ancient times before the technology comes. Then we also talk about what are the terminologies or commonly used words sa traffic management. Siyempre, kailangan muna natin alamin ang mga termino na madalas ginagamit sa traffic management before we start the discussion. Upang sa ganon, dahil mapapadali natin maintindihan kung ano ba ang sinasabi ng ating instructor. Then we will talk also about the major causes of traffic congestion sa chapter na to. Okay, so first we are going to discuss about the historical background of transportation. So, ano-ano ba yun? So, we have modes of transportation: manpower, animal power, and wind power. Manpower, we have walking or traveling by foot. In English word, pedestrian, and Latin word, pedester, which means to travel by foot. So, early man who had no domesticated animal, na wala silang mga alagang hayop na kayang magdala ng mga gamit sa from one place to another, yung ginagawa nila by walking, traveling by foot. So, pinapasan nila yung mga gamit nila para mailipat sa ibang lugar. So, yun yung ginagamit nila. Then, we have also carrying pole. Diyan, nakikita natin sa picture. So, yan yung una sa carrying pole. And then, backload and tamp line. So, sa backload and tamp line, goods are carried on the back. So, pots are carried on a wooden framework supported by tamp line across the forehead. Then, the load is held on the back by strap passing over the chest. Yan yung ginagawa nila para dalhin ang mga gamit from one place to another. Then, sledge on rollers. Another one sa manpower is sledge on runners. Okay, then the last is trevious. So, sa trevious, dito, hinahatak or dinadrag yung mga gamit nila by the use of human or animals. So, yan, hinahatak nila. Yun yung isa sa modes of transportation, sa manpower. Then, another one is animal power. So, this is the domestication of animals. Sila, may mga hayop sila. Yun yung ginamit nila para magdala ng mga gamit, lalo na kung maraming gamit na kailangan dalhin na hindi kaya ng tao lang. So, yun yung ginawa nila. And then, mas mapapadali at mapapabilis yung paglalakbay pag ginamitan ng hayop. So, they use the animal power. Then, we have the last modes of transportation is wind power. Man realized the energy from the mass of moving air and they learned and utilized such powers from the moving air to lift up the cargoes or the goods rather than to drag. So doon pa lang nalaman nila may energy pala sa mass of moving air na kayang buhatin pataas yung mga gamit rather than to drag or hatakin, di ba? So yun yung nalaman nila na mayroon palang magagamit through the moving air. Kaya gumawa sila, nag-invent sila, balloon, kite, so yun. So those are the invention that airlifted transportation. So those are the modes of transportation. We need to define first the word transportation. So when we say transportation, it is the movement or conveying of persons, not only the persons, but also the animals and goods from one place to another. So, makikita natin dyan, there is a word of conveying, meaning paghatid or ihahatid. So, the word transportation, yun, the movement or conveying, ihahatid yung mga tao, hayop o bagay from one place to another is called transportation. Kasi pag tinanggal yung conveying, ibig sabihin, iba na yung meaning niya, hindi na transportation. Pag tinanggal yung conveying, okay? So when we say transportation, this is the act or process of conveying from one place to another is called transportation. Then we have the elements of transportation. We have three elements. One is infrastructure, the other one is vehicle, and the last is operation. Ano ba yung pagkakaiba nila dito? So ano-ano ba ang meaning nila? First, the infrastructure. So, meaning, these are fixed installation that allows a vehicle to operate. Meaning, the word fixed installation, hindi na maililipat sa ibang lugar yung ginawa dyan. Fixed na siya. Ibig sabihin, naka-steady na siya. It consists of a way, terminals, and any facilities for parking and maintenance. So, halimbawa na lang mga infrastructure dahil pinag-usapan natin ay tungkol sa transportation. So, yung mga kalsada, mga bridges, yan yung mga infrastructure na kung saan dyan dadaan ang mga vehicles na may mga dalang mga kagamitan or cargos na ililipat from one place to another. Kasi pinag-uusapan nga natin is transportation. Another one is vehicle. A vehicle is non-living device that is used to move people goods. Unlike sa infrastructures, so sa vehicle, it moves along with the cargo. Of course, syempre kailangan din ng riders. Hindi gagana yung vehicle kung walang drivers or riders. Syempre, si vehicle dadaan din sa infrastructure, di ba? So kaya, andon talaga yung elements of transportation na infrastructure. Kasi yung mga vehicles na yan, dadaan sa mga fixed installation na sinasabi nating infrastructure. Hindi naman makakatawid si vehicle kung walang bridge, lalo na kung may ilog. Paano maililipat sa ibang lugar, sa kabilang lugar, yung mga gamit nila or mga cargos kung walang infrastructure na ginawa kagaya ng tulay kasi dadaan doon si vehicle. Then the last is operation. This refer to the individual or entity. Meaning, refer to the individual or entity. So tinutukoy na dito yung mga agency na kung saan they are operating the vehicle and infrastructure to make the transport easier and safe. Gagawa sila ng mga tulay, daanan, or mga traffic signs, traffic signal lights, para magkaroon ng maayos at safe yung transportation ng mga sasakyan sa one place to another place. Yun yung operation. They are the one who operate to make the transport easier and safe. So those are the elements of transportation. Now we move to fundamentals of traffic management. Traffic management, we need to understand first the commonly used word or the terminologies. Of course, bago tayo mag-umpisa sa ating discussion, sa ating lecture, alamin muna natin yung mga terminologies na mostly common used word na ginagamit sa traffic management para madali nating malaman, maintindihan yung mga sinasabi ng ating instructor. Dahil pinaliwanag na o binigay na yung kahulugan sa atin ang mga terminologies na ginagamit sa traffic management. We have terminologies arterial, highways, or roads. These are high-capacity urban roads that direct traffic from collector road to expressways or freeways. Kasi dalawa kasi ito eh, arterial highway at saka collector highway. Arterial highway, dito yung keyword pa lang nandyan na. It is a high capacity urban roads, kagaya ng mga expressways, mga freeways. So yun yung arterial highways. Kasi pag lumabas ka ng arterial highways at napunta ka sa mga residential properties, yung daanan doon, yung road na yun, ay hindi na arterial na high capacity urban roads. Magiging collector highway na siya. Kasi sinasabi sa collector highway, it also known as collector road or distributor road, which connects from low to moderate highways or roads to arterial highways such as those entering residential properties. Sabihin na lang natin yung sasakyan natin nasa expressway. And then paglabas natin sa expressway, doon na tayo papasok sa residential properties. So pagpasok natin sa residential properties, hindi na arterial highway ang ating dinaanan, kundi collector highway na. Kasi nandun na tayo sa low to moderate highways, hindi na high capacity urban road. So, yun yung pagkakaiba sa collector highway at saka sa arterial highway. Then, another one is highway. So, ano ba yung pagkakaiba sa highway sa road? Pareho lang naman silang kalsada na madadaanan. It means the entire width between the boundary lines. Isang kalsada, sabi dito, the entire width, kalapad ng kalsada between the boundary lines. Sa gitna, may boundary lines dyan. This is called the highway. Pag nakita nyo na entire width between the boundary lines, meaning this is a highway. Kasi pag sinabing road, it refers to the entire surface. Surface yung ano niya, pinaka-keyword of any street open to public traffic. Kasi si highway, entire width between the boundary line. Si road naman, entire surface of any street open to the public traffic. So yun si road. Yun yung pagkakaiba sa highway at road. Of course, there are classifications of road. We have national road, provincial roads, city roads, municipal roads, and the last is barangay roads. So, ano ba yung pagkakaiba sa national roads, sa provincial roads, and city roads, municipal roads, sa barangay roads? So, first, we have national roads. Sa national roads, these are the roads or streets that are interconnecting from the provinces and cities. So, national roads, again, they are interconnecting from the provinces and cities. While the provincial roads, these are roads that are interconnecting from municipalities and cities within the province only. Kung si national road, interconnecting provinces and cities, si provincial roads naman, interconnecting municipalities and cities within the provinces. While city roads, these are the roads wherein they are interconnecting barangay or barangays within a city. So, yun yung pagkakaiba. And then, how about municipal roads? Ano yung pagkakaiba sa city roads? Kasi si city roads, they are interconnecting barangay within a city. Of course, si municipal roads, these are roads that are interconnecting barangay within a municipality. How about barangay roads? How they differ to municipal roads? So, when we see barangay roads, these are or those are roads that are located with a barangay which connect sitios or places within a barangay only. So yun yung pagkakaiba, the classification of roads. Then another terminology used in traffic management is road user. Ano ba yung road user? So it shall be a person, any person using the road, including the drivers, not only the drivers, of course, the pedestrians, the cyclists, and commuters. Kasama na dito yung mga nagmamaneo, yung dumadaan na naglalakad sa kalsada, yung mga cyclists, nagbibisiklita, yung mga commuters na kung saan sumasakay sa mga pampasayrosan. So, sila yung mga road users. Then, we have roadway. Roadway, it refers to the part of the traffic way over which vehicle pass. Diyan si vehicle dumadaan sa roadway. How about shoulder? Ano yung pagkakaiba sa shoulder sa sidewalk? Okay, baka dito tayo malito. So, si shoulder, it refers to either side of the roadway, especially along the highways. Either side, sa kabila or dito sa kabila, nakalagay of the roadway, especially along the highways, ang tawag sa kanya is shoulder. So madalas dito dumadaan yung mga cyclist, yun yung shoulder lane. Kasi si sidewalk ay iba. It refers to paved walkway. Meaning, paved walkway along the side of a street na kung saan dito naglalakad yung mga pedestrians. Dito tayo dumadaan sa portion ng street or highway between the curb lines or lateral lines of a roadway. Ito yung sidewalk intended for the use of pedestrians, hindi for the cyclists or motors. Tawag sa kanila is sidewalk. Unlike sa shoulder, they are intended also for the pedestrian and also the cyclist or vehicle, motor vehicle, yun pwede. Pero dito sa sidewalk, hindi pwede dito yung mga cyclist at saka mga motor vehicle, kundi si pedestrian only. Sila lang pwede dumaan dito. Then, another one is through highway and throughway. So, ano yung pagkakaiba sa through highway sa throughway? When we say through highway, it means every highway or portion thereof on which a vehicular traffic is given the right of way. And at the entrances to which the vehicular traffic from intersecting highway is required by the law to yield right of way to vehicles. So napapansin nyo sa picture na yan. Sabihin natin yung vehicle na blue. So may right of way siya pumasok kasi wala namang tumaraan pa. What if kung may sasakyan pa dyan na dadaan, of course, kailangan mag-yield si vehicle blue. So, mag-give way siya. Padaanin muna yung isang sasakyan bago siya pumasok. So, this is called the right of way. Kasi pag pumasok siya and then nagkaroon ng collision, doon malalaman kung sino talaga yung may violation. Dahil sa alam niya yung right of way niya. Sasabihin naman niya na ako yung may right way. Kasi nasa loob pa ako, pumasok agad siya. Ayun tuloy, nabangga siya. So, yun. Si magkakaroon ng violation yung isa kasi wala siya sa right of way, di ba? Dapat mag-yield siya or mag-give way. So ito yung through highway. It means every highway or portion thereof in which vehicular traffic is given the right of way at the entrances to which the vehicular traffic from intersecting highway is required by the law to yield right of way to vehicles. Yan. Dapat mag-give way tayo kung alam natin na may dumadaan pa. Pag clear na siya, ready na tayo mag-cross or pumasok sa intersection. Kasi yung throughway, iba si throughway. It is a highway that has limited entrances and exits. So halimbawa sa mga toll gates, di ba? Sa expressway may mga toll gates. So such as expressways, freeways, or motorways na kung saan limited yung mga entrances and exits. When we say intersection, it means any level, crossroads, junctions, or forks, including the open areas formed by such crossroads. Yan, yung nasa picture na yan. So, yung una is crossroads. Yung pangalawa, junction. Yan yung junction. And another one is fork. In a simple way or in a simple meaning, when we say intersection, it is an area of a roadway created when two or more roadways joined together at any angle is called intersection. Different angle ng roadway niya, pag nag-join together, so matatawag na natin yang intersection. I got broads in Atlanta, just to throw me in the family, credit cards in the scammers, getting no licks in the band, legacy.